today. From Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta, Georgia, it's week one of the NFL on EA Sports. As we'll see Baker Mayfield and the Atlanta Falcons versus Jalen Hurts and the Philadelphia Eagles.
It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. We thought the old place was loud. Somehow this place got even louder a short time ago as the Falcons were introduced to this sellout crowd. We're set to go as the Falcons get ready to match up with the Philadelphia Eagles. Hello again, everyone. Brandon Gaudin, so happy to be with you to kick off this much-anticipated 2021 season. With me in the booth as we begin our sixth season together is, of course, Charles Davis. And CD, so much to watch for coming up. What are you keeping an eye on?
Well, Brandon, I'm ecstatic to be back with you, of course, and we've got a good one right here out of the gates. I'm interested in seeing some of the changes in 2021. Running backs and wideouts, even linebackers wearing single-digit numbers. But even more than that, I want to see the changes defenses have made, because last year, we averaged 49.6 points per game. That's the highest ever by three full points. Can these defenses make an adjustment and start to catch up?
Yeah, passer rating, CD, an all-time high. Completion percentage, also an all-time high. So as you said, will those numbers continue to climb northward, or will the defenses adjust? A first down throw for Mayfield. And this one nearly picked off. Kind of surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but get away it does, and it's second down. Second and 10. Opening carry of the game for Cordarrelle Patterson. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here, up to the 34.
There's so many definitions of a complete back. I think most people think a guy who can block, a guy who can catch, and a guy who can run. But how about when you put it all together as a runner and you can fake people out, you can be shifty, and also run with some power and break tackles, as we just saw on that pickup.
Third and short, so didn't need much, but got a little extra on the backside. Nice run.
Chewed up the yardage, didn't he? To me, that was offensive line with leverage, good blocking angles, taking on a stacked defensive front. And once they chopped that little hole in the beginning, he took it and rambled.
And just the third play from scrimmage, wanted to avoid the three and out and did just that. And a high throw there as this is knocked away, down to the ground and incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Mayfield's throw taken in by Ridley here. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 41-yard line.
And that's another Falcons first down, courtesy of a catch there by Calvin Ridley. Now in his fourth season, he's coming off of his best year yet in 2020. 90 catches, close to 1,400 yards receiving. He continues to ascend up the charts as one of the top receivers in the NFL.
And it's Reuben Foster in on the tackle. After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5. To throw, Mayfield. Oh, what a catch by Pitts. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 16.
Kyle Pitts out of Florida was the 4th overall pick in the 2021 draft, the highest a tight end has ever been taken. A lot of people thought he was the best player in the draft as well. Wearing number 8, he's a matchup nightmare for any defense. Good grab there for a first down.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Play action now. Here's Mayfield. And that is caught. Oh, what a catch at the 5-yard line. And the Falcons are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that'd be pinpoint here.
I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
On second down now, it's Patterson. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Cordero Patterson taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Falcons are on the board here first in the season opener. A long opening drive, but a very successful opening drive. We call that methodical, I guess, when it takes that many plays.
Methodical and almost like a boxing match where you're hitting them with body blows. They can withstand them here. Look, they gave up the touchdown, but you don't feel like a knockout is there. But they keep doing that in the fourth quarter, that's when the knockout occurs.
And it becomes tough for that defense if they're on the field that long. We'll see if they can continue that in future drives. Crew able to connect on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Following the touchdown, here's Crew to kick off. Here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Well, for the first time, we get our look here at the Eagles offense and Jalen Hurts, the second-year quarterback out of Oklahoma.
A lot of expectations for Jalen Hurts this year, but he has the support of the franchise, including the man who owns the franchise. Had a 4-game audition at the tail end of last year and did enough that the Eagles sent Carson Wentz to Indianapolis. They're expecting Jalen Hurts to be their quarterback of the present and the future.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. This is complete to Watkins on the slant. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So from the 36 now, first and 10. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Second and 2. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. Fast footwork by Sanders. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. First and 10, it's Hurts. There's the former quarterback, Greg Ward Jr. 7 yards, the pickup there.
That's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we talk about finding the soft spot. Defensively, how do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do, because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot they want to get into. That's what we call not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. But it's hard to do, because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards him. I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position, because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down. From the gun, it's Hurts. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. He was looking for Miles Sanders out of the backfield, but now it'll be third down. Charles, a look there at the Falcons draft class for 2021. And this was the first pivot point of the draft. What would the Falcons do it for? Many thought this was a spot to take their QB in the future, thinking, hey, maybe we won't pick this high again for a long time. Instead, the physical attributes of Kyle Pitts were too much for them to pass up.
And many still expect quarterback Matt Ryan to play at a high level, and they think they can win right now. And I know a lot of people are interested in seeing Kyle Pitts match up with Julio Jones and Calvin Ridley in running their offense. Of course, that won't happen now with the Jones trade to Tennessee, but still a dynamic offense, and Kyle Pitts will see the ball come his way a lot as a rookie.
That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. Here's Sanders. And good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
They call it a loss of a yard there. And that's going to make it fourth down. The kick by Elliott is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So from an offensive perspective, at least able to get on the board here right in front of the two-minute warning.
Yeah, now it's time to talk about complimentary football, isn't it? Because if the defense can force a three and out, there could be enough time on the clock to then get the ball back for their offensive guys and maybe put some more points on the board before the half.
So for the second time in this one, we get set to see the Falcons' offense. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Falcons! Calvin Ridley, 74 yards. And the Falcons are able to show off their quick strike ability. Charles, there aren't really any slow receivers, but there's fast and then really fast. He's really fast, and he showed off the afterburners there.
And that he is, because when he took off, I was thinking there's no chance that he could actually reach him with that pass. Yet he did, and he's still sprinting. And just think about what that does for everyone else on his team, because his ability to stretch a field opens things up for the rest of the receivers on the team.
Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. So back onto the field, here come the Eagles for their second drive. They finished off their opening drive of the campaign with a field goal on the last drive. Now they'll search for a touchdown here on this go-around, first and 10. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive, and he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down. We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Throwing is Hurts. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Watkins. First down now, but that clock rolling. They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. So, CD, big changes for 2021. Of course, last year we had the expansion from 6 to 7 teams in each conference making the playoffs. This year, the headline, the addition of a 17th regular season game. What did you think when you heard the news that this was happening?
Well, my first thought, partner, was finally, because we've heard about a 17th game coming for a long time, and now here it is. So the beautiful part about all of it is that 17th game is going to be like these interdivision, interconference type games that are going to match up and play out over a four-year period. And that's kind of cool. And I was looking forward to seeing some of the matchups that were going to come out of that for that 17th game. And could that be the game that decides a bunch of division titles?
And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 36. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. He's going to drop this down to Sanders. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. From the 27, Hurts. Open man is Goddard, the tight end.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback, a hot route, so to speak.
The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Quez Watkins in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Elliott good on the extra point, and the lead is down to 4. Maybe time for one play on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away. Williams now on the return. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. Play of the half, Mayfield. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee.
Hey, baby, this ain't good.
So that PI call will give him one more play.
And it'll be an untimed play as well. Now the half will end after this one, unless there's another defensive penalty.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. 64 was Matt Prater's record. This would top that by a yard. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short. No good. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome back to football, everybody. We've got a full slate of 16 games here to start the new season. So let's take...
All right, we will save the week one highlights and apparently get right back to the action here in the third. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And we will not have a run back here as the second half starts with a touchback. Out come the Eagles now as they'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
We're paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks. I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers, a little bit more to the perimeter perhaps. But above all, play your game.
Second half will start with a run by Sanders. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Second down, back to Sanders. Only a yard on the gain there, and that'll set up third and 13.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
And incomplete. They tried to drop it off, but he couldn't hold on. So it appears they're going to come up empty on this first drive of the second half, still down by that slim margin.
Yeah, and that's okay. You know, when you sit and analyze it, they're not happy about what happened, having to go to the bench. But this gives them a chance to let their defense do some work while they on the sidelines go over what they're doing offensively and formulate a proper plan.
A very nice punt that time, but they get 11 back on the return. And the Falcons will be taking over first and 10. Here comes the Falcons offense. It's their first possession of the second half now. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up.
And this is caught inside the five. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the two-yard line. It's a big play there for Atlanta. He went swinging for the fences on that play. Didn't quite get in the end zone, but, boy, they're set up pretty now.
Okay, that play just happened. Let it go. Time to defend the goal line, bring some all-out pressure, and try and knock them back.
Well, that didn't take long. One play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation. Patterson. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you're
without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
On second and goal, Mayfield. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down just inside the 5-yard line. Reuben Foster able to take him down. It's a loss of 3. A big play to start the drive got him in this position, but this defense has held firm since, and now it's third and goal. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's fourth. They'll try and run for it, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Cordarrelle Patterson. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Falcons will extend their lead. So fourth and goal, their head coach gave that offensive line one more chance to punch it in, and this time they were successful.
They certainly paid off the coach's confidence, didn't it? And how about the fact that they stayed with the ground game? Because a lot of times in that situation, partner, we see teams try and roll the quarterback out, give him a little run-pass option, and treat it like a two-point conversion play. In this case, they went with a little bit more power and got it done.
Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Philadelphia's offense ready to give us another look. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Second down, back to Sanders. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down. Here's Hurts to throw. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. The decision to tuck and run gets him three, but that's not enough. Now it's fourth. The Eagles send out their punter now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. Elsewhere, a third quarter score. And the Colts adding to their total as they're able to stretch their lead in that one. And we'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And that one incomplete. They try to sneak in a deep ball with the clock running down, but to no avail as time will expire on this third quarter of play. To throw on second and 10, Mayfield. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Going deep here for Landry. And that nearly the pick that they needed. He couldn't pull it in, though, and it's fourth down. Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. Just a yard return there after a punt of 49. And the Eagles will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10. Now Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a two-score game, and they need points on this drive and in a relatively quick manner. Now left side on the swing pass. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks. And they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down.
Well, that play really didn't fool them. They completed the screen pass, but for lost yardage, a really nice play by the defense.
Throwing again on second down, Hurts. Going deep here for Watkins. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Daron Harmon. And the Falcons are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, ah, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on-the-job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Following the interception, Mayfield. Over the middle, that's caught by Ridley. No gain there on the completion, second and 10. The defense loves to hang their hat on that, don't they? You get a guy that catches the ball, but you stop him for no gain.
Without a doubt, because they're also used to trying to catch people after the catch, and they miss. And that turns into what? A huge play. We've seen it so many times. In this case, though, catch was made, put down right on the spot. Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
That's caught left side to tight end Pitts. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
And that pickup of a first down That's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Mayfield on first down. Oh, Ridley has it. What a catch. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. First down, Mayfield. Looking left side. That's caught by Landry. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
58 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it at them. We've got them now.
Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Cordarrelle Patterson with now 3 week one touchdowns. And the Falcons are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. That time a 9-play drive. And it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. Philadelphia's offense ready to go again. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance, to be frank, not to be proud of here as they trail big in this fourth quarter. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That's complete to Ward. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Now they got to get to the line quickly. But first down, Hurts. He finds his tight end, Goddard. That's complete. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46. And now they're in the hurry up. He'll hit Watkins on the crossing route. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Hurts throw there, taken in by Smith.
And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. Looking to throw again on second down. Hurts. And oh, it'll be intercepted. intercepted. Picked off by Daron Harmon. And the Falcons are going to take possession here as they've got it at their own four-yard line.
So many times we end a game, and as we're recapping it, we're talking about what offenses did and how they won the game. Let's flip this one over. The defense, they frustrated the offense the entire ball game. That's why they're walking out of here with a victory.
And they're going to love to walk out of here with that as their final act, that interception. Good way for them to end it. Well, the lead late in the fourth, but Mayfield's going to throw it. And he's got the hook up to Landry. It's a big play there for Atlanta. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
And it is incomplete. I had a defender running right with him, and now it's third down. Mayfield now from the 50. There goes a deep ball, end zone. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play. So it doesn't affect the outcome, but a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lanyap, a little extra on top.
So time runs out. It's a victory for the Atlanta Falcons. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the